Hello and very good morning, class. How are you all? I hope you all are fine. I have already told you about the chapter, okay? I have already told everything, every type of sentence in our chapter, everything I have explained you. And I already sent you a video of a revision video of this lesson, okay? Now we are going to revise exercise of this lesson. So first one, tick the correct options. Tick the correct option. First one, a group of words that makes complete sense is called, it is a definition, so it's called a sentence, not a subject, okay? I hope you understand first one, okay? Now come on to the second one. A sentence always begins with a capital letter. A sentence always begins with a capital letter, okay? Third one, a sentence ends with a sentence always ends with a full stop, okay? But in these options, only capital letter, small letter and full stop there. So here the correct option is full stop. But when they ask a sentence ends with a full stop also, ends with a question mark also, ends with exclamation mark also, okay? So all these are there, okay? Fourth one, we put a question mark at the end of an interrogative sentence. I told you when they ask question, it all about interrogative sentence. It's not an assertive sentence or a imperative sentence. Come on to the fifth one. An imperative sentence expresses a command. Okay. An imperative sentence expresses command, request, entreaty and all that. Sixth one. What a great singer Tansen was. It is an exclamatory sentence because at the end of the sentence there is exclamation mark. So it is exclamatory sentence. After that, moving on to the section B, that is identify the kinds of sentence in the following. First one, may I help you? Question mark is there. By seeing question mark, we can say that it is an interrogative sentence without having any doubt. Second one, stop laughing, it is giving you a command or order that stop laughing, so it is an imperative sentence. My doctor told me to take rest. Third one, so it is a simple sentence, we can say that the assertive sentence. Next one, fourth, please let him go, okay? Please let him go. It's a request. So, it is an imperative sentence. Move on to the fifth. Anu, hand me your shirt. It's also an imperative sentence. They are ordering Anu that hand me my shirt. Sixth one, how kind of you? After that, exclamation mark is there. So, it is exclamatory sentence. In seventh one, what a foolish man you are. It is also exclamatory sentence because at the end of the sentence, exclamation mark is there. Eighth one, have you solved the puzzle yet? It is an interrogative sentence because question mark is there. For you, it is very easy to identify all type of sentence because I have explained you very well. So, I don't think there should be any doubt. Ninth one, he stole my books. He stole my book is the assertive sentence. Okay. 10th one, respect your teachers is the assertive sentence, okay? Respect your teacher is the assertive sentence or a simple sentence. Now, moving on to the next page, which is on page number 8. Here, on page number 8, in section C, sentence mix-up is there. Means, the sentence are not arranged in a proper order, okay? Then, you have to arrange it a proper order or in a meaningful order. You can say that when they give you a complete sense, that it becomes a perfect sentence, okay? Like, first one, the went the shop to boy. Is this a current sentence? No. The correct one is the boy went to the shop. Second one, he ball tennis hit the hard. Is this correct? No, it is wrong. So the correct answer is he hit the tennis ball hard. Move on to the third one. Very play went she early too? It is wrong. She went to play very early. Moving on to the fourth one. For take walk a dog thee. Take the dog for a walk. Now moving on to the five. Go and finish your homework, then go to bed. Moving on to the six. Buy to go for school, going new, for they are clothes shopping. Oh, it's a very long sentence actually. Now, so the correct one is, they are going for the shopping to buy new clothes for school. Seventh one, you going movies today for our? It is wrong. So the right one is, are you going for a movie today? Eighth one, can they swimming? Can school? But go there too like that. So eighth one, they can't go to school but they can go for swimming. So it is all about the exercises and lesson number one. So it is a full revision of lesson number one. If you are having any doubt still in this chapter, then you can ask me in the comment section of the Google Classroom. Till then, bye bye. Thank you and have a nice day, everyone.